guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today's video, I wanted to come on here and share with you guys some of Sephora Collection's new launches. Obviously, I work on the product development team, so I am very biased in my reviews on these products. I know, you know, the ins and outs and the sweat and tears and cheers and joys and wins of each of these products, so I do have a very big tie to them. But you know, I still want to talk to you guys about, you know, the products I've been working on, why I really like them, and if it's anything of interest to you guys, if you guys want to try them out and, you know, see for yourself and test them out, I think you'll also fall in love with Sephora Collection. Let's get on to my first product, which is our hydrating lip balms. Oh my goodness. These retail for $5, okay? Like, you guys, my team and I, we negotiate hard for that price point. We put avocado butter, cucumber butter, and plant squalane in here. Like, really, really nourishing, good ingredients that you would see in other high-end lip balm brands. We do have in clear, rose, cherry, and berry. And for the most part, you will find me carrying one of these with me at all times, just because I love the formula, but I also love how easy and convenient it is. So the applicator is a tube with a slanted applicator tip, and I love it just because it's easy. I don't have to look into a mirror to apply these at all. Travel friendly, just throw it in your purse, throw it in your bag. I love the formula of this too. I want to give it like a texture of like frosting. That's kind of what it is to me. It's not like super, it is thick, but it's not like a salve, like an oily salve. It has some like moussey, rich depthness to it that I love. And also the fragrance of it is a minty vanilla scent. Anytime I go to like really like those like fancy chain steakhouses like Fleming's or Ruth's Chris, they always at the reception aisle always have those like butter mints that are so good. They're like white and creamy. I don't know if you guys know what I'm talking about, but this smells exactly like those butter mints. It does leave a slight film throughout the day on your lips, so it's not something that's going to be quickly absorbed into your lips, but it does a really good job moisturizing and hydrating. And again, like, I just find myself all the time just applying. My personal favorites, definitely the clear. I'll use this on a day-to-day basis, but I think my favorites are the rose shade, which is what I was wearing before I kept putting on the clear. But it's just a really nice mid-tone, medium warm pink, which I really like. And then cherry is kind of like your classic pinky red shade, and then berry is more of a purple shade. They're not super pigmented, and again, like any of the shades, I can do this without a mirror. It just gives your lips a little bit of a tint to it, but it's nothing crazy. It's just really subtle and nice, and it's just really nice when you see like all the hard work you put into something finally come into fruition and like a physical sample. You know, I can't really rave enough about it, and for the price, you really can't beat it. The next product I want to talk to you guys about is our translucent setting powder. Where do I even begin with like talking about how dang difficult it was to create this powder, but it was so worth all the sweat and tears and just hours and hours and hours of phone calls to get, you know, the right formula, the right component for this project. Looking at this product, you're like, it's a setting powder. It's so much more than that. You know, we went through so many issues with finding the right component for this. Some components were breaking, some components were just not compatible with the formula, some components, you know, the sifters were coming loose during stab and compat. It was just a journey to get here, but we're here. It's official, she's out, and I cannot be more proud of this component, seriously. You have your standard setting powder component, which is a cap, a jar, and a traditional sifter. So the sifter doesn't have anything fancy to it. It's a traditional sifter, like I said, so there's no like dial or anything like that that's preventing the powder from coming out. So I would just like to warn you With that in mind, if you're gonna travel with this, you know, the powder itself is actually a little bit more thicker. It's not like a finely loose, kind of like a micro, what's it called? Like a silica based powder, like the Makeup Forever HD, you know, like the really white, finely milled ones that feel like air or nothing. It's not that type of a formula, so the product doesn't come out of the shaker as easily as that. That was Lola. So we use a really special finely milled talc that really does an amazing job at blurring out your imperfections. There's something about working from home that like Lola loves to sit on my lap during like the day. And like it's fine most of the time, but like sometimes it just gets... The other thing that we added into this that I love is kaolin clay, because I have really oily skin and kaolin clay is really good for helping absorb excess oils. So this product mattifies me throughout the whole day. I also use, you know, like mattifying primers, mattifying setting sprays. So like I'm all about the matte, but this definitely does help to blur out my imperfections, help minimize my pores, and then also keep me pretty matte throughout the day. There are some days when I just don't wear any makeup. I'll just wear moisturizer and this powder just to help me mattify my skin so I don't feel as like I'm getting greasy throughout the day. This does have a matte finish in my opinion, and this does not leave any white cast. We actually did a couple tests with through outside labs to make sure that there was no white cast. And then my marketing manager on the team, she actually is more deeper complexion than I am, and she tested it out. She approved this formula, no white cast, so you know what's good. This is truly a translucent setting powder. It's really just going to help blur imperfections and mattify your skin without depositing any color. So for every day for me, this is what I use. And I also still bake with this on an everyday basis, just because I like that aspect of baking, because I think it just blurs my pores a little bit better, and then also like helps mattify like my T-zone areas and everything. This retails for $15, which is super competitive, especially with all the other setting powders in Sephora. I will say I have tried a lot of the other setting powders that we carry at Sephora, and this is a contender. If anything, I like this more because the price is better and the performance. So good. So good. Okay, so my camera just died, so sorry, like the angle might be a little bit different. But we only have one product left, so I'm gonna go into my last Sephora collection product that I wanna talk to you guys about. And I do actually wanna mention that I'm not talking about all the Sephora collection products that we launched this month, just because I really wanna highlight the ones that one I've tried, and then also the ones that, you know, I've really been loving, and also like the ones that I've worked on. This product in particular is actually a product I did not personally work on. My team worked on it, but I personally did not touch this. But I wanted to talk to you guys about it because I'm obsessed with this formula. And this is the Sephora Collection Clean Bouncy Eyeshadow Palette. But starting off with the packaging is clean. It is a all cardboard palette, which means there's no plastic used or involved in this palette, which is great. And it also is a friction fit closure with an elastic band, just to really help, you know, give it an extra just another level of security when you're like traveling and making sure this doesn't actually come open when you're like in your makeup bag or anything. So I love the sustainability of, you know, cardboard packaging personally. Sephora Collection, which I don't think we get enough credit for, we have such an intense blacklist that we really abide by, and we make sure our vendors are abiding by it. We have a blacklist when it comes to our core products, and then we also have a blacklist when it comes to clean, which is kind of like a step above the core products. But, you know, we have a blacklist for packaging, formulas, for fragrances. We have a really intense regulatory team that does a thorough job at reviewing all the documents and making sure everything is up to standard and to our standards and liking when it comes to like the submissions our vendors send. So I think we should get a lot more credit for the blacklist in terms of like marketing, because you guys don't really know this. Like, you guys are just seeing the product, but we're in the back end of it, you know, really fighting hard to make a really good clean product. And even if it's not Sephora clean, just know that our core products still have a lot of requirements that they need to pass in order to go to market. And you know, we make sure that our blacklist is actually pretty intense, because there are a lot of ingredients out there that are not good for your skin. I will leave some links down below for you guys to see like what the Sephora clean list means. The formula of these eyeshadows is what really stands out to me, because it's a texture that is just easy and beautiful. Like, two things in my life that I like. It is kind of like a cream to powder hybrid texture. I wouldn't say it's like a liquid at all. When you touch the formula, it's almost like a putty. Like, you can move it around, it's malleable. I've seen a lot of reviews on the Monarch palette saying that people are using these with their fingers, and I personally don't like to use these with my fingers, just because I feel like the color payoff isn't as intense as with a flat brush. These are totally doable with a more fluffy brush to get more of a diffused look and a blended look. But I personally, if you want the most payout for this, use a dense synthetic packer brush and just go all over your lid. That's how I personally love to use these on a day-to-day basis. And the thing I love the most about these is that they have absolutely no fallout. Every single time I use a powdered eyeshadow, it doesn't have to be like a high-end formula. It could be really any powder eyeshadow formula. I will always get powder fallout underneath my eyes and like in that little like nose area when I'm like blending out eyeshadows. This provides absolutely no fallout because of that putty texture. It's absolutely amazing, and it gives you the most beautiful shimmer sheen to your eyelids. Like, it just gives a nice like opacity to your eyelids too. It's not like a thin shimmer, it's a good opacity because of that cream texture. You compare these with powdered eyeshadows for more of a like complete look, I guess. But for everyday, for me, I really just go in through like one or two shades and just pack it all over my eyelid, and I'm like done. This actually is a shade extension from the Monarch palette. So the Monarch palette launched first. I believe this was last year. Same concept, but as you can see, like, the packaging is a little bit different, a little bit different of a color. I personally love the color story of the Monarch palette more so than the Dragonfly. I love the Dragonfly just because, okay, I really like them both, honestly. But if I had to choose one personally for me, I would choose the Monarch just because I love the shades in here more. They're a lot more neutral, more wearable tones for me. Whereas the Dragonfly, it's still a neutral palette and a wearable palette in my opinion, but you have a little bit more pops of color. So you're getting a green, you're getting some mauve-y tones in there, you're getting like kind of more of a pinky shimmer here. You know when you have that shirt that, or that dress, or that type of clothing that just looks so good on your figure, like it just complements your body shape so well that you want every single shade in it? That's pretty much how I feel about these palettes. Like, I love the formula of these so much, I just want every single shade in them. I will say the shades in these are all shimmers, so there's no mattes in here. They're all pretty much the same finish. Some are a little bit more glittery than others, but for the most part, they're pretty much all shimmer shades. Finger swatches, brush swatches on the back of your hand do not give it justice at all. Like, I'm even gonna show you guys, like, you can see it there, and it, like, it comes off, but, like, what's really impactful is, like, the packer brush with the eyeshadow directly on your eyes. That's where you're really going to see the magic. I'm hesitant to even do, swatches at all, because like, it's just not gonna do it Jenny justice. Nope, that looks really sad. I personally have oily skin, oily eyelids, and I have a hooded lid, so usually cream eyeshadows will crease on me. But these ones, if I use an eyeshadow primer, I currently use the Urban Decay Primer Potion. If I use an eyeshadow primer, I can use these alone and not have to set them with a powder at all. I would really recommend trying these out if you are in the market. This does retail for $18 and you get 6 beautiful shades. So that's it for my video. I really hope you guys enjoy just me talking about some of my favorite Sephora collection launches that we did this month. You know, I understand that this video is a little biased. It's kind of weird because it's not like I'm the brand owner of Sephora Collection, like stating that this is the products that we launched. I'm just like a part of the team that was like behind the creation of these. So I have like a different tie to this in terms of just like my blood, sweat, and tears went to some of these products. Not these products, because I didn't work on these, but like, you know, the lip balms and the setting powder. I don't know, like let me know in the comments down below if you like these types of videos, if you want to hear me talk about the launches and, you know, some backstories behind them. You know, I'll be honest, I'm just really proud of all the work that my team and myself, we've done to create these products, and I want to share it with you guys, you know. That's it for my video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll talk to you guys in my next. Bye!